for YouTube. This is Jason, aka Bit Junkie. I hope this video finds you doing well. It is Tuesday, February 6th. We're going to talk about trading and specifically market direction today. We talked about in the last video a little bit about top-down analysis, and we got into analyzing Bitcoin. But today we're going to talk about market direction using time to mark trend lines specifically. And this is going to give us the best glimpse thus far into the actual way that I would trade the market. We're going to build price. We're going to do a top-down analysis on Bitcoin. And we're going to look at the actual trend lines in conjunction with the price levels. And it's really going to put a picture together on how you actually trade the market. Okay, so we're getting to a level where you can actually use some of this stuff for a fundamental reason to enter a trade. Now, I'm not giving financial advice. These are just my views and my analysis of the market. But I think once you combine this with the previous information, a trading plan will start to form in your mind. Okay. So let's get started with that. CryptUnite Global, that's our group. That's our community. That's Jim on the left. That's me on the right. My name's Jason. We formed CryptUnite Global. If you're watching this video, I believe you should be a member of CryptUnite Global. It's free. All it is cryptocurrency enthusiasts coming together. We're talking cryptos, sharing experiences, saying what we're doing in the market, what works, what doesn't work. We're analyzing the news that comes out. We're doing everything that's crypto related in the space. And we even community wise, we got a trading bot and we're testing out a trading bot. Speaking on that, I need to make some more adjustments to the settings and we'll do an update video on that within the next day or two. All right. So stay on the lookout for that. I know a lot of you within the community are eagerly awaiting the results from the trading bot. So we're going to get to that pretty soon. I'm really excited about cryptocurrency space and Bitcoin. And a lot of you say, well, why would you be excited? The market is down. It's probably 50% of the value that it was 2 weeks ago. Here's the thing. In investing and in anything trading related, if you're doing what everybody else is doing, you're probably about to lose money. It's the truth. 95% of the people in the market lose their money. Not some of it, but all of it. Okay. So if you're doing what the majority is doing, you're losing. That means you lost. You're supposed to do things that are completely uncomfortable and feel contrary to the market position. When you see it on the news and they're telling you about it and you're following that, you're a lamb to the slaughter. Don't do it. And so you have to find reasons within your own analysis to enter into things. You know, we catch a lot of flack in the comment section from some people because we've tried a lot of different things in the cryptocurrency space. Lending platforms, we're into mining, we did some ICO stuff, maybe not so much on the videos, but we've done some ICO stuff. We just announced the Mint Builder last week. And, you know, I'm a mitigated risk taker. You know, I mitigate my risk based on my exposure level and I try stuff out because if it on paper looks like it can make sense, then I give it a shot because you never know what's going to hit and what's going to miss in this game. But you have to be in the game. And what I have a problem with is there are a lot of sideline commentators. You know, it is so simple. Me and Jim talked about this the other day. It is so simple to say, you know what? I'm going to buy Bitcoin when it hits 6,000. I'm buying. I'm getting in. I'm going hard. I'm going to have $10,000 to put in. And I'm excited. And you feel like a risk taker. And because of cryptocurrency's low adoption rate, unproven history, yeah, that's a pretty good risk. Completely different than the person like me that's been buying Bitcoin since 12,000, 14,000, 15,000. So when it drops back to six, you're at a 50% loss. Do you still have the resolve to buy it then? Can you put another $10,000 at when it's $6,000 because you feel like it's on sale when you're negative 50% drawdown on your account? Totally different set of biases right there. And if you haven't been in those shoes, you might not understand this game. So, and being a trader, this is what you do. You can't let the results, you can't let the results of something else dictate what you do on the next move. You analyze everything that you get into. You create a plan ahead of time. And if it hits your levels, you jump in. Your objective, you get in and you do it, regardless of what's happened to your other positions. But most people, and apparently 95% of people, are not built that way. So I said I would never do this, but you know what? I am going to do this. To you haters in the comment section, that don't have any skin in the game, you're going to just be ignored. Because it's easy to be on the sideline and spectate and talk a bunch of trash, but you've done nothing but commentate and kept all your money in the pocket. All the rest of you people that are in the game, that are in our community, that are trying out different things, we're going to keep pushing and we're going to keep doing things the way that we're doing them. And we're going to find a way to make as much money and extract as much profit out of this currency jump, this cryptocurrency expansion that's happening, as humanly possible. And we're going to try a lot of different things to get there. And there's going to be losses along the way, but that's just part of the game. We're just going to stick to it and keep pushing. And if you have to believe in it, and if you don't, then I mean, there's nothing wrong with that. You should get out, because like I said the other day, we're all visionaries. This is something that's brand new. It doesn't have a lot of history, and we're all taking risk. Anything you do within this space is risky. Every single thing you do. And I would go as far as to say none of it is really more risky than anything else. It's all risky. It's unregulated. So we're all taking some risk, but let's get out here and figure this thing out. I'm really excited about the position, though. The chart is starting to look really, really good. All right. So let's get into that. Bitcoin, we're at $7,097 as of right now. You know what? Let me show you something else, too. This isn't advice on what you should do, but let me just give you an example of a trader or risk taker investor mindset. Look at the VOR coin real quick. Price of the coin is 28 cents. A lot of people say, okay, the VOR coin is crap, is junk, blah, blah, blah. It's a lending platform. It's all about the crash, everything. Okay, that's great. We'll do a VOR update one other day. All right. But let me show you an example of arbitrage. So this is 28 cents to buy the coin on the platform through their exchange. And this is how they allege that they make money. Let's go to VOR. $154. You go to the markets. Now, I'm not going to try this arbitrage because I don't have an account on Coin Exchange, but this is what arbitrage would represent. Now, I would be careful of the volume because you've got some liquidity issues. But in theory, if you had $5,000, I never have a calculator ready. I didn't plan on doing this. But since we're talking about being nimble in the market, let's look at it real quick. So if I had $5,000 and I bought Devor coin at that price, I'd have 17,000 coins, right? And if I then sold them, so let's round this down with fees. Let's say it's $1.40 per coin. There might be some slippage in there too. It's $25,000. You see? Now, I don't know what the ask price is. That's why I went with 140. But in theory, you could take $5,000 and make $20,000 with arbitrage. This is what arbitrage is. You have one place willing to sell it for this, and then you have another place willing to buy it for this. And you simply buy from one place and sell to the other. It's arbitrage trading. Now, there's volume involved. They only done $55,000 in volume in the last 24 hours, which means they may only be able to fill up to $5, $10, $15,000 worth of orders at any one time. There could be slippage. So their ask price could be, you know, $1.40. And by the time you got the whole order filled, you could average $1 or $1.10 or 98 cents or 90 cents per coin by the time the slippage happened to get all of the order filled. But the point is, that's arbitrage. Buy for this price. Sell for that price. Plain and simple. All right. Players in the market, people that are willing to take risk, you do that. This is what you do. There's somebody sitting at home today that made $20,000 doing something like that with $4,000 or $5,000. This is what's out there if you're willing to get in the game. Okay. All right. So let's get to Bitcoin. This is a 15-minute chart. I think this video is going to be way too long. All right. So time to mark trend lines. Let's talk about those. Time to mark trend lines. They're called supply and demand lines. And the reason they're called that is because the ones that are going up are defined as demand lines because the demand is outpacing the supply. When the trend is going down, the supply outpaces the demand. But the beautiful thing about a time to mark trend line is it's 100% objective. 100% objective. And what do I mean by that? All right, so let's get a trend line out. I'm getting better with this software too, guys. All right, so let's pick any spot on the market. Let's go right here. All right, and if I'm going to pick this spot right here, this swing high, I think we all understand what swing highs are. Swing high is when the market goes up, and if you look at the top of the wick, it's higher than both the wicks on both sides of it. That means that was the peak height of these three candles. So anytime you get to a swing, you'll see a swing high. That's a swing high. That's a swing low. 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 That's a swing high. I think that's a swing low. And so on. Okay. I hope you understand that. So what time to mark trend lines or supply and demand lines do is they're dynamic in whatever the latest swing low or swing high is. If it's a swing high, you go to that high and then you go to the previous high and it gives you the direction of the market. All right. So we got the time to mark trend line. We're going to use this high here, which means the previous swing high to that one was this one. So I'm going to draw my line right here. All right. And what that does is that gives me the angle of this is a supply line. So this is the angle of the supply or the angle of the downtrend. Okay. But there's always a counter line. There's always, so at this point right here, the demand line was this one, right? And you're always redrawing them. And this is what makes them so good, is that they're dynamic. It's not subjective. If you ask someone to draw me a trend line on this section, they would just draw you a trend line here, you know. But which highs you use are, it's completely objective, and it adjusts to price action as price unfolds. And that's very important, very important. Okay, so how I use them. So, I mean, you should get a chart out and practice. Every time you see a swing high or swing low, go find where the trend line should be. So here's the low here. I'm going to look at that one. So I'm going to go to the previous swing low, which is right here. And I'm going to start it there. And I'm going to attach those two. And there's my trend line. Okay, and anywhere on the market you see a swing high or a swing low, you can do that. This one will be hard because the highest one's going to be back here off screen. So I'll stay away from that. But it's an objective rule. Whatever the high is, it's the previous higher swing high. Wherever it is where you connect it to. So I think this one, it would be, I think this is higher. So that would be there to there. Okay. Now, the lines themselves are just basically telling you market direction at the time. But the more important thing, and how I use them to trade, is markets have polarity. So the polarity of the trend line or the direction of the market could be up or down, right? At any given time, it could be up or down. And it's within the space of time that changes too. Like, for example, your daily direction could be up, weekly direction down, monthly direction up, hourly direction down, 15-minute direction up. And that's where the map of price, the roadmap of price that you create when you do a top-down analysis is so important, because it lets you orientate the directions, but those are superseded by price levels where the direction doesn't matter. So for example, if the price is going down and it's going to retrace 60%, so price went down and then at the bottom of that move, the polarity of the market is going to change to up. And it's going to go up. And what's going to happen is you're going to see consistent trend line breaks. Like, let me see if I can find an example. Okay, so market went down here. We're going to draw a trend line. So the market's going down. There's the trend line right here, right? So right here, it broke through the trend line, which means this downward move is now invalidated. The direction is now up. However, there's going to be support or resistance, I mean, somewhere in here, because this is a 61% retracement level, you know, for this whole down move. So even though the polarity of the market changes to up when this trend line is broken and now the direction is up, that doesn't mean it's going to go straight up, because there's support and resistance areas that you have to consider. So that's what price, that's what creating a map of price will do. And we're going to do an example of this with Bitcoin in a second, but I want to get the concept in your mind first. Okay. So you want to practice drawing your lines, because you want to make sure you're always right. You know, pick any low. If I pick this, so we're going to go very current. So here's here's the latest swing low for the market on this chart. So that's the direction of the market right now. Okay. I think that's accurate. I probably have to look at these to see which one of these is the actual swing low, but they look to be the same. So this is the current direction. And here's the thing. The trend line broke. Okay, hold on. I didn't do that right. The direction was down on this 15-minute chart. Price broke through it, and the current direction is up. But let's look at something. We know from experience using fibs. That there's going to be some resistance right here at the price that price is about to get to right here. So this could be the price that says we're wrong. If the market isn't in fact going to continue up, somewhere between here is where it normally reverses. So you have to know that. So if you're, when this trend line break happened down here, ideally I would have got into the market somewhere down here and been out of the market before I got here, because this is where you don't know what's going to happen. You don't know what's going to happen here. So you know, you'd rather, the thing about trading is that be in the areas that have the highest probability that you're going to win, right? So ideally, I'm in somewhere down here, and this one doesn't look like it retraced far enough back for me to get in. So I probably just would have missed this trade, because I ideally want to buy as close to the bottom here. When that trend line breaks, I want the market to come back before it gets up here, be able to get in, and then ride it up to this area before it gets there. And then I can get out of the market without the risk of having to figure out what's going to win. Is it going to go higher and make a higher high for the day? Or is it going to reverse and this downtrend we've been in is going to continue? I don't want to have to guess about that. What I do know without a fact, that there's going to be some kind of reaction, without a shadow of a doubt, I should say, there's going to be some kind of a reaction right here. I don't want to be around for that. I want to make my profit in the most probable and most predictable section of the market. Okay, so that's what it's always about, putting the odds on your side. There are no guarantees on anything, but trend lines are important because they tell you current direction to a T. 95% right, time to mark trend lines are going to always tell you the direction. And I'm going to tell you, the most important thing is the change in polarity. This is the, if I was to teach a course on change in polarity, I promise I could charge $20,000 for this course, because this would be worth its weight in gold. The change of polarity is the by far the most predictable time in the market that there is. And what do I mean by change of polarity? So let's take a look. We're going to use the same example I just showed. And I'm sorry if this video is going to get long, but this is kind of like a training thing. So this is what it is. All right. So right here, price broke down. All right. So for me, I would have liked when this price broke down, I would have liked, before it got down to this area right here, I would have liked if it came back up, and I would have sold it here to ride down this way to get out of the market before it got into this area where you don't know what's going to happen, right? But never mind that. So the polarity of the market is now down in this section. All right. My point is, when the market polarity changes, is the most predictable section. If I would have known that the polarity changed right here, I would have had an opportunity to get in right here. When it goes from up to down or from down to up, that next couple of moments is the most predictable things, is the most predictable area of trading. All right. So let's show another example. So the polarity is now down in this run down. So now we're looking at whatever that's called, supply lines. All right. So there's the supply line after that candle was made. And actually, we didn't get another swing high, so that stayed the one. Okay. And then it was broken here. This change of polarity is the most predictable. This is the most predictable part of trading. You know that when the market goes from down to up, the highest probability that it's going to continue up is right there when it first happened. And but you have to get in there before you get to the area where you know more sellers that made this thing go down are going to be waiting to jump back in. So the key is once that polarity changes, if you can learn how to trade that section, you'll have a very, very, very winning strategy most of the time. All right, so let's use some of this for Bitcoin. And I'm going to try and get off this video. All right, so let's go back and we're going to start from the very beginning with Bitcoin. I'm going to show you what I see happening. All right, so here's Bitcoin. This is the monthly chart. All right, so the last swing high. And so we're going to plot levels first because, you know, we talked about fibs. So this is the last swing low. And here's the swing high. All right, for Bitcoin's price for the month. So let's step our game up a little bit. We're going to this is how I would create my chart. All right, so I'm going to put that there and let's blow it up. Let's blow it up. All right, so that's the 61% Fibonacci level. And this is the 78% Fibonacci level right there. All right. All right, so let's get rid of the fib because now we know where the levels are. So this section in between these two lavender bars, this is the 78 and the 61. This is the zone. There is absolutely zero way long term. Now, we're looking at a monthly chart. So the turns can take longer to form. You know, it's a monthly chart, so it may take two candles for this thing to, you know, this momentum that we had going down to slow down and stop. So it's not going to happen in a day. And some days you get a false stop. And we'll zoom in on the weekly chart and look at this. But I would not sell in this area hoping for the market to go further down. That's a fool's errand, in my opinion. You have really low odds that the market's going to continue down lower than what these two bars are. So between 86.29 and 57.94. So between, you know, basically $5,700 and $8,600, there's a ton of buyers here waiting to buy this. Because you know what? The last trend line we could draw on this chart is going up. This isn't a swing low yet. This market is so fresh, this move doesn't even have a swing low. Nowhere to be found. It hasn't even made two candles yet completely. This shows you how young and immature this market is, okay? But the last trend line break we had was right here to the upside, and there's the swing low. So this market direction monthly is up. So this right here, this down, long down move on this monthly chart is just a retracement of an up move. That's it. Now, there is a price that says we're wrong. You know, somewhere, come on, software. You know, somewhere around 14,351 to 17,000, somewhere in here, there's going to be a ton of sellers on a monthly level looking to sell this thing back down. So there's going to be some resistance there. It's not going to go straight up, I don't think. But I would not sell in this zone. This is where the buyers are waiting. And it may take a week or two for it to turn, but this is where we're at. All right, so now we're creating the roadmap. So now this, we know what we look like on a monthly chart, so we drop down to a weekly chart. And I hope you guys are gleaming something from this. Okay, so now we look at it and we're like, okay, it looks a little bit more like there are buyers here because you've got this long wick on this candle. It's like, okay, maybe there are some buyers in this zone. Even though price went way down, it's not outside the realm of normal. Okay, let's go in another a little bit further. Let's go to the daily chart and look how price reacted when it got to those levels. All right, so here's when it first hit the 61. We've got this reversal candle, and then we've got this pattern right here. This is normally a reversal pattern. Right when it hit the 61, we could have thought it was going to reverse. But you know what? The market tricked us, and it reversed on us again and kept going further down. And that's what happens. You know, there's a lot of whales in the market, and they come and they push the market around, and they want to get it down to a cheaper price. So here we are again with it looks like a reversal pattern candle forming. I'm going to tell you, there's only going to be so many times that you're going to get reversal signals in a buy area like this that they're not going to be legitimate. Okay, so I'm inclined to think that we're not too far away from an actual turn. Now, here's where your time to mark trend lines come into play. I don't know if you guys remember, if you watched the videos, if you've been following these trading videos that we've done. I think it was last week we plotted. We plotted this right here, and we talked about that when the market gets into a tight consolidation, what normally happens is an explosive move out of it. Okay. And at the time, we were on the 61% retracement. That was around right here from the weekly chart. And this is where this bottom kind of was put in. And then we had this consolidation. So if I was a betting man, I would say I would bet up. But, you know, there's no way to know. So I wouldn't trade it, because normally when price compresses like this, it explodes out of that compression in one direction or the other. Well, we got our explosion and it went to the downside. But you have to understand that it went to the downside into a buy zone from a monthly chart. This is a huge area. Now, what's been difficult is to live through all of this, right? This has been difficult. Every day it's bad news and, you know, the sky is falling and Bitcoin's going to zero. This is because each one of these represents a day, and it's hard to live this. If you bought, imagine if you bought up here and you bought at 18,000, and then down here, it's down to 11,000. You know, you lost $7,000 or whatever the equivalent is that you invested. And then it goes back up and you've got a little bit of hope, and then it falls back down. It's falling and falling. You get discouraged. You get scared. Fear comes in. Everyone starts selling, and it's a self-fulfilling prophecy, because as everyone keeps selling, it just creates more and more selling pressure. And that's what ends up happening. So that's what happens. But you have to understand where we are in relation to price in the big picture. This is all part of the plan. This is the buy zone. We're now there. Now, if this gets invalidated and we can't hold here, then we may have a problem. But as it stands now, we don't know yet. So let's look at the time to mark trend lines. Okay, so the current trend line, here's the swing high right here, and then this is the one that's higher. So here's the line. Okay? That's the line. So the polarity of the down of the polarity of the daily chart is down, because the last break was, you know, here and then actually here. This is a swing low, so we would have put another one somewhere way back here and price closed below it. So the polarity of the daily chart is down. However, we've got a bullish candle forming here, and as price goes to the right, if price, and we're at a buy zone, if we punch through this, the polarity of the daily chart is going to turn to up. All right, let's go to the weekly chart. See what the polarity says. Weekly chart. Okay, so I'll show you where the last trend line break was going to be. And actually, this isn't a good example. Well, yeah, I would have missed that trade too. But I mean, I don't trade off of a weekly chart. You trade off some type of intraday chart. So you can, because you should have been in on this move right here down, and then maybe just out before it got down here. You know, so you can trade in between the levels. Once you get really good at reading the market direction and the polarity, and you can identify the areas that say you may be wrong, and you can plot all of them on your chart, you can trade between those lines and make profits all day long. All right. But so you come down here, we're in the buy zone. If we're going to draw a trend line from the weekly to determine the market polarity, it's down, right? However, how close are we until it changes to up? You see? So if on the daily chart, we get a reaction here, and as we go over, we're getting close to this line. You know, two more weeks, we're going to be close to this line. Now, if price breaks through here, closes way down here and continues down, that invalidates all of this, and you draw new lines. That's the thing about time to mark trend lines. It's only the most recent lines are the important ones. So it's dynamic. It doesn't matter what price does. It adjusts to the current price for you. So you always know what the current trend is. Right? So this trend is currently down, but the trend line that would need to be broken, that would change the polarity, is not very far away. And if we get a nice size rise, if, you know, if price does one of these numbers and comes up this far, or maybe not this week, you know, let's get another candle here. And then on this candle here, if price lands somewhere in here, now the polarity of the monthly chart would be up. The polarity of the weekly chart would be up, and intraday, it could be anything. You know, retracement back down may change the daily polarity to down. And then that day you may just trade down moves. But understand that it's just a retracement in an overall larger upward move. And this is about perspective and creating a roadmap for price. This is what this is all about. So I'm encouraged because we just had, it looks like to me, with this reversal pattern here, and I mean, this is a little predicting, so you don't really want to get into predicting. You want to trade what's there. But right now, I like market polarity changes. I don't like, if it's already in a downtrend, I don't count the continuous pushing through and making new lows. And that's trading the trend. And I'm not really great at that. I like to spot reversals. And I like to get in as early as possible when the polarity of the market changes. We're not very far away from the daily polarity to change to up if we can push through this price. And I'm more inclined to think it's going to push through this because we're at a serious buy zone. Serious buy zone. This is the 78% retracement of the weekly chart, and simultaneously it's the 61% retracement of the monthly chart. This is the 78% retracement of the monthly chart. This is a huge buy area. Huge buy area. No guarantees, but if we get this thing to punch through here, it's going to be, that's going to be the beginning of the market turning around. And rising tide raises all boats. I think everything within the space is going to become more alive as the market goes up. The overall talk about Bitcoin will be a little less doom and gloom. Mining will become instantly more profitable. As much as people hated what happened with BitConnect, you know what's going to happen? When Bitcoin starts booming again, and it eventually will, I don't know if it's going to be this week, next week, a month from now, whenever it starts booming, people are going to go looking for some kind of way to accumulate more Bitcoin. And lending platforms are going to be back viable. I don't know if they'll be viable from a standpoint of they'll be doing the correct actions and they'll be sustainable, but they'll be viable as in people will start searching them back out. So the value of the coins and things like that will go back up, and we'll have more people jumping into more stuff that, you know, people think is really, really risky. So this is just how it works, because people are going to be hungry to get as much Bitcoin as they can. So if you can hunker down and not be a scared off by the FUD and all the bad news and the doom and gloom, this chart is setting up for a nice size run for Bitcoin. It's so young. I mean, I think I did this comparison the other day. I mean, look at this chart. It basically has had one major up move, and we don't even have a place to stick our trend line. We don't have a swing low yet. That's how brand new this market is. So I hope you guys gleaned something from that. This might be a 40-minute video. I never know until I turn the video off. So like the video, subscribe to the channel, hit the little bell so you get notifications whenever we make a new video. Join the community, CryptUnite Global. We'd love to have you. Trading bot videos coming soon. You guys have a wonderful afternoon. I'll talk to you later.